the Dart as well, which is a train that goes all along by the coast. Now, this is the main street here in Dublin. We're just going to drive down now the main street in Dublin, and you're going to see Daniel O'Connell's statue just here in the right-hand side. Most of the main streets in Ireland, they're either called O'Connell Street after Daniel O'Connell, or they're called Patrick Street after St. Patrick, the one who brought the Christianity to Ireland. And Daniel O'Connell, we call him the Great Liberator, because he was born during the penal times, which meant that if the people didn't change religion, well, then they didn't have any rights. So that went on for about 100 years. And so he trained as a lawyer, and he in France and in England, and he came back, and he was determined to change the fate of the Irish and to improve their situation, but without violence, because he had a horror of violence. So he organised these big mass meetings, rallies and all of that, and didn't see any change in his own lifetime, but thanks to him it did change eventually. So that's him there. You'll see him in most towns now around Ireland. And here he is surrounded by the angels. And if you look closely now, and we're going by, you might see some bullet holes and the wings and arms and that of the angels, because most of this street was destroyed. We had several sort of wars, if you like. We had the 1916 Rising, then we had the 1919 War of Independence, and then we had negotiations with Lloyd George, and that was partly successful. But anyway, that divided Ireland really in two, and the six counties then became part of the United Kingdom. And that led to a referendum and a civil